Howdy mates, how are we doing today? Here's a part two video over at the Canyonlands National Park. As I said before, we're at the Islands in the Sky portion, which means we get to have an overlook of the different canyons that are seen here. Here we have an excellent example of, great example of sedimentary geology right here. Now, each distinction of rock layers each have a different story, but really something that you need to know while here is a lot has happened in this area in terms of deposition. Now, what I mean by deposition, that refers to basically the transport and the delivery of sediments, whether it comes from the ocean or the river, rivers, or even ponds too, but mostly it comes from flowing water. And as a matter of fact, to go through a couple of the different layers that you can see here that I was reading up on. So basically where I'm at, which is towards the top of the rock face, we're actually on some Navajo sandstone, which comes from the Jurassic period, which was basically a little over 200 million years ago. That usually has the lighter color that you can see towards the top there. But then just below that, we have what is known as the Kayenta. So that it's basically like right... It's like right there. Well, I can't even do it. But it's the layer just below that lighter color. And that Kayenta formation mostly came from the deposition of rivers and lakes after the seas retreated. Now, as you go further down, of course, you run into some Wingate sandstone. That's what gives some of that smooth texture right there. And as you get past that, you've got the Chinlay formation. If you look carefully, you see some of that greenish-brown. That is your Chinlay formation. It stands out from the rest of the formations, just because none of the other rock layers really match its color, honestly. Then below that, where you start to see some of the more... kind of resembles looking at a cake. That is your Moen Kopi formation. So that comes from basically the Triassic, which ranged from 251 to 206 million years ago. Then just below that, you can see it, especially out there in the distance, you've got some white rim sandstone. And then, last but not least, right down here, that is your Oregon rock formation. So that's just a couple of examples of the different strata that you can find here. But the key takeaway, really, to take from this is just a result of rivers that once, or basically... sediment beds that once spanned here, and due to the activity of uplift, from tectonic plates, it resulted in some of the formation of these canyons, especially after river downcutting and erosion. Now, rest assured, this is not Grand Canyon. This is in Utah. So Bringing up the subject of Grand Canyon is even more complex when it comes to the geology of the area. I'm just very grateful that it finally cleared up a little bit. I think you actually can see, because there's two known rivers that range through here. You've got the Green River and the Colorado River. And I think just beyond that distance, if you look towards the center of the frame, you can see the Green River. So it just goes to show that water can really change a landscape over the course of time. All right. Take care, you guys. And you just gotta think too that sand dunes once spanned here. Now you get to see an ancient relic of that past. Rocks truly tell the story of what has happened. All right, take care.